Man, this show really deserves more love. If you haven't watched it yet, go watch it, seriously. Hello and welcome to a figure review. Today we're taking a look at the Robot Damashii, or Robot Spirit, Raihite Muga from Back Arrow. And starting off, as always, with the articulation, the Muga has a weird head system. There's a front-to-back hinge here, here, and here, and then a swivel at the top there. I don't know why they didn't just make that top joint a ball, because it would have just given it more articulation, but whatever. You can go about that far back and forward, and rotate pretty good to either side. This sort of ring on the back can hinge up and down and can come off pretty easily, which is good, because it's better it comes off than breaks. There's a joint here in the chest which looks like a ball joint, but it can rotate front to back and hinge up and down very slightly. There's a little bit of wiggle front to back, but it's not very much. Doesn't really matter, because if you want to get the arm across the chest, you just bring it up like that anyway. Shoulders are on a separate ball joint up here, and then the arm is on a ball joint and a swivel, so you get a ton of range there out of that. Elbows are on the beautiful, I like to call it the Vifom joint, which is a hinge and then a ball joint, so you get a rotation at the elbow and then a second bend, so full bend there. And the hands, as always, on a ball joint. The waist is, as far as I can tell, on two ball joints at the top and bottom. A ridiculous amount of back movement there, and pretty good ab crunch too, to be honest. And pretty much unimpeded in whatever pose you want to get it in using those joints. Hips are pretty great, honestly. There's a up and down hinge there to bring them out. Then there's a ball joint and a second ball joint down here, like a 30-minute missions kit. So, a ridiculous amount of articulation there. This piece is on a hinge to get out of the way for wide stances, and in case you want to bring the leg up in a weird way. So, despite the actual design of this, the hip has a ridiculous amount of range. There's nothing that gets in the way there. Double jointed knee, which follows the sculpt beautifully. This looks really good when it's bent. And weird feet, but hey. The Muga has weird feet, kind of Rozafon looking actually. There's a ball joint for the toe, and then there's a side-to-side hinge up here, and then a front-back hinge down here for the heel. Kind of weird, but it works. Overall, the articulation on this thing is amazing. Thankfully, because this is a figure, it doesn't require any color correction. Though I will say I kind of wish they went with a flat yellow instead of the metallic. It works okay for like the head gem and this little strip on the neck, but the eyes look kind of dead unless you get a side light in on them. It's inlaid. I may just end up painting it, actually. Looks okay under the studio lights, but when it's on my shelf, he's a little dead. Now, as for accessories, you get two closed fists, two sort of chopping palm hands, two sort of splayed, relaxed hands. They all have pretty much perfect sculpting. I don't really have any complaints there. Now, you also get the flight wing ribbon, whatever you want to call it. These are ball jointed in here, which is nice, so you can get nice poses out of them. And this attaches onto the back of the head by swapping out this piece. You just pull it down from the top, because there's a little peg that holds it in. Swap it out for this one, plug this one in. Works fine. You'll see it in a bit anyway, so I'll leave it off for the time being. You get two effect parts, which are absolutely beautiful. You get a little one for punches, and it's clear with airbrushed translucent blue on it, and like I said, it looks amazing. And you get this massive one, which is also works as a punch or a kick. Kick has two pegs here, which peg onto the feet. This is the same as the punch, which means you literally pull off the hand and stick this onto the ball joint. Makes me a little concerned, to be honest, but hey, if it works. And finally, for accessories, you do get a stand adapter, which clicks on to the crotch like every other stand adapter you've ever seen. And as for a quick size comparison, This thing's pretty tall. I mean, it's a figure, but yeah, the Bry heights are pretty big, relatively speaking. I can only imagine how large some of the others are. So, to wrap this review up, the figure is great. I really only have one complaint, and, well, two, but one I really wish that he had holding hands, because I think it would be fun, but I can forgive that. The other thing is I really wish that the sword was here. Not having that, it feels kind of incomplete, though I understand why. Yeah, they probably wouldn't want to include it. Anyway, the articulation's great. I absolutely adore how they did all of the gem parts with translucent blue plastic with no like metallic blue paint in anywhere. It's all translucent blue. It is beautiful. They nailed it. I'm not a huge fan of the metallic yellow they used for like the eyes and the little light on the chest. I really wish they just went with a flat yellow there. Mostly because the metallic just doesn't really pick up light that well, and I think a flat would have looked nicer, but I can ignore that. That's still fine. This really does everything right. It has plenty of articulation. You can pretty much get it in whatever pose you want. Aside from the accessories I mentioned, it comes with everything you'd want it to. It really just does a really good job. I like this a lot. This is definitely one of my new favorite shelf pieces. And that's all for this video. Thank you very much for watching. Be sure to let me know what you think down in the comments below. Subscribe and hit the bell to be alerted for future reviews. Come chill in the Discord. Follow me on Twitter, if that's even still around. And consider supporting me on Patreon, so I can keep bringing you videos like this. And, as always, until next time, happy building.